I saw an ad for a Time Life book. A guy jumped out of an airplane, fell 30,000 feet, his chute didn't open, and he lived to tell the story. I would have loved to hear that story.
And jumped out of the plane. And his chute didn't open.
Yeah, I heard about that. It's Time Life books.
Honey, the garbage disposal doesn't work.
That's okay, we can fix it ourselves with Volume 2, Fixing the Garbage Disposal. And when that doesn't work, they have Volume 3, Learning to Eat with a Hook. Volume 3, Happy Now, You Cheap Fuck? A lot of weird commercials. At Ultra Slim Fast, that shit doesn't work. A shake for breakfast, a shake for lunch, and you're shaking at 3:30 when your blood sugar plummets. And then a sensible meal. Hey, if you could eat sensibly, you wouldn't be on a fucking diet.
Hi, I'm Henry Block of H&R Block with reason number 55. If you are called in for an audit, H&R Block will go to court with you.
Not as a legal representative. Well, then what, like a well-dressed friend? What the fuck do you need in there for? What, so you could drive your car home after you're arrested? 8 out of 10 people suffer from hemorrhoids. What, do the other two enjoy them? Why are hemorrhoids called hemorrhoids and asteroids called asteroids? Wouldn't it make more sense if it was the other way around? Ow, my asteroid. But then if that was true, you wouldn't be a proctologist, you'd be an astronaut. Have you seen that Anusol commercial? You ever have one of those burning itches you can only tell your doctor about? Well, who else can you tell?
Citibank, yeah, my asshole burns.
No, I don't have an account with you. What do you go to the drugstore?
Yeah, my asshole burns. You know, it itches and I scratch it and it burns.
Yeah, maybe you want to talk to somebody that works here. I remember mine burned once. I ate some jalapeno peppers or something. And the next morning I thought I was shitting battery acid. I'm not kidding, it burned so bad. I came this close to sticking a popsicle up my ass. If it would have been one of those square ones, it would have been right up there. But I ain't sticking no dick-looking popsicle up my ass. But the only thing that stopped me was the fear of getting caught. Kind of weird if my mom and dad walk in with company, you know.
And this is Robert's room, and you're like, ooh, oh yeah, you're the boss. You're the boss.
Sick thing about that is it would probably work, actually. Kind of embarrassing when you're changing at the gym. Hey, what, you shitting your pants?
Nah, it's a fudgesicle. A jalapeno burned my asshole.
No more, really, please. I have a dog. I went to the pet shop to buy dog food. They actually have hemorrhoid cream for dogs and cats. I love my dog. I'm not rubbing cream on his asshole. What's he thinking while you're doing that?
Hey, you like this? Does this feel good? Yeah, what's next?
Weird commercial. So I saw a Tampax ad. They had a Tampax in a wine glass, open like a flower, and it says, "What does this tell you?" you that I'm never having wine at your house. I feel bad for women, I really do. You're constantly bombarded with these stupid commercials. They make women look so dumb. Susie, how could you work 8 hours a day and look so young and fresh and vibrant? Stay Free maxi pads. Did you hear the question I just asked you? What the fuck are you thinking about? And that Summer's Eve herbal douche, do you tell your lover you use this stuff, or you just surprise him and let him get there and go... Pine? Gee, how natural. Now I know what it's like to go down on my dresser drawer. What can you say? Honey, you weren't sliding down the banister again, were you? They have this stuff. Summer's Eve, water and vinegar with mesquite. Hey, honey, we fucking or barbecuing? What's happening? The one with the mother and daughter walking along the beach. Ma, what's feminine hygiene spray? I don't know. Ask the pelicans that are following me. Like guys could ever talk to their dads like that. Hey, Dad, I took a shower and everything, and my dick still smells funny. Well, then stop smelling it. What the fuck are you smelling your dick for anyway? What is it with you, the popsicle up your ass, and now you're smelling your dick? They don't have commercials like that for guys. Hey, Dad, come here for a minute. Does my dick smell funny, or is it just me? You know, Bob, you need some Summer's Eve pina colada dick mist. A couple of sprays and the girls think they're blowing someone in the Bahamas. The worst thing about douche is when you go into the supermarket and your wife goes, look, since you're already going to the store, could you get me a bottle of that Summer's Eve stuff? It's almost worth the risk of getting caught shoplifting. That computer scanner fucks up, you know.
Price check.
I think it was $10. $10? There's no way this is $10. $20, I'll pay $20, please. Can't charge you $20 for this.
Price check on the Summer's Eve herbal douche.
Fuck it, I don't want the douche.
Fuck it, he doesn't want the douche.
And now they have condom ads. They have these new condoms, magnums, for the guy that needs a little more. What a great marketing idea. What guy could buy anything but that? Condoms, please? Magnums? No, I'll take those Tom Thumb rubbers you have over there. Those magnums are too big for me. They fall off. I have to use a twist tie. I don't like it. Really. Last time I used a magnum, I lost it. 9 months later, my kid came out with a shower cap. My daughter came home from school the other day, and she said, Dad, they taught us about condoms in school, and they showed us how to put them on and everything. And I said, on what? She said, they rolled it down on a cucumber. Yeah. Boy, are they setting them up for a letdown. The closest my dick's gonna be to a cucumber is if it turns green. Guys worry about that penis size. I think that and when you start losing your hair, it's two things that threaten your masculinity. Yes. Well, it's nice that you're that open about it, sir. Yeah, I'm losing my hair. At least I'm not parting it way down here and combing it all the way across. Well, that only looks good as long as you're walking that way all the time. Guys worry about that when you start losing your hair. That or the size of your dick, it threatens your masculinity. I don't worry about the size of mine because I found out it just makes my hair fall out faster. Losing your hair is not that bad. Losing your pubic hair, that'd be kind of fucked up because Not so many places sell crotch wigs, really. But the commercials would be great, though. Not only am I the president of the company, here's what my bald dick looks like. You can get your penis enlarged. I saw ads for it in the paper. It says penis enlargement, and then in bold letters, it says for men only. Kind of shitty if your wife had a bigger dick than you. So now I see all those wig ads on TV. You can swim in them, you can skydive, you can scuba dive, you can make love in it. What, the wig itself? You tell the girl, wait, before we do it, I gotta take my wig off first. Oh, while you're doing that, let me get these grapefruits out. Shit, since you're doing that, let me get this pepperoni out of here. Two more things, you have a picnic going. I was reading Cosmo magazine. They had this survey in there, and they said that a lot of men suffer from premature ejaculation. Yeah. That's not true. Women suffer. What guy suffers?
Oh no, I'm coming. Woe is me.
There is no such thing. When it's time, it's time. Baby, I'm gonna come.
Wait.
No, you hurry up.
No, but I want to come with you.
You have 3 seconds, hurry.
Well, yeah, but
time's up, that's it. Why do women think they can tell you to wait?
Don't come yet.
Once you hear the word come, it's over. You're doing everything you can not to come yet. You're fucking it in your head, you're going 395 divided by 14.3. I remember when I was growing up, my dad said, think about baseball when you're doing it. That'll prolong it. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, it's the bottom of the ninth. Base is loaded. Two outs, two strikes. And there's a finger up my ass. Give me that. So they said if you have this problem, they have a thing called the squeeze technique. And the way it works is, just when the guy's ready to come, you grab his dick and squeeze as hard as possible, and he will not have an orgasm. Ever again. But you can go skeet shooting with his balls when they fly out of his ass. Squeeze somebody's dick when they're gonna come. That's like putting duct tape on your mouth when you're gonna puke. Nobody does those. It's gonna find some place to come out. Just...
I'm coming. Oh no, you're not. Hey, your nose is running.
I saw Dr. Ruth on TV. She says that it's normal to masturbate. Who's fucking her? When I was growing up, my mom said, Bob, when you masturbate, all your dead relatives are watching. But then I figured, who are they gonna tell? It got a shitty if that was true, and then you die and get to heaven, and like your uncle's waiting for you. Hey, Bobby. It's weird when your wife thinks you're masturbating, but she doesn't want to come right out and ask you, you know. And it's like, honey, did you use my Nivea lotion? No, why? Because I just bought it yesterday and half of it's gone. Nivea's not good. You know what's good? That Polydent or whatever it is. That's your, man, talk about getting a grip on reality. I used to jack off a lot. I was actually thinking about having one of my balls removed and having a lotion dispenser put in right down there. So. Don't even have to go to the bathroom. That's why I can never understand how anybody could ever go to confession and admit that they masturbate. You think that guy doesn't know who you are? If he called you on the phone, wouldn't you know it was him? You don't think he knows your voice behind that thing? Yeah, I jacked off Monday, Tuesday, twice on Wednesday, in the car on the way over here. And then you go to some church function and he goes, hey, Joey, how's that masturbating problem? And he goes, shh, my parents are here. That's okay, your dad jacks off, he told me. Or how do you know what he's doing while you're telling him the shit that you do?
Yeah, yeah, I had Susie over and I was feeling her up a little bit. Yeah, yeah.
Got her blouse off, I was squeezing her tits. Yeah. Stole some candy from the 7-Eleven. Fuck the candy, get back to the tits.
No, nothing against religion, but no guy could live to be 60 or 70 and never come ever in your life. Your prostate would be like a cassava melon. Every priest would be a hunchback with a hunch full of cum. You'd hear him walking down the street, swish, swish, swish. Hey, Father, how you doing? Don't touch the hump.